Okay, so the way you can think about this question is by looking at the first message and why it makes sense to have 2 bits per symbol. So you can represent this bit pattern in a tree. So when a new bit comes in, it can be either 0 or a 1. If it's a 0, the next symbol can be another 0 or it can be 1. In the same case here. So if there are 2 zeros, it is an A. If it is a 0 followed by 1, it is a B. If it is a 1 followed by 0, it is a C. If it is 1 followed by 1, it is a D. So that is why you need to ask 2 questions to reach either of these symbols. But what happens in this new language? So in this new language, A occurs 50% of the time. So we can directly ask if it is A or not A. So let's represent that as 0 or 1 and let A be 0. So now we got our A as just a 0. Now, if we go on the 1 branch, we can again ask if it was a 0 or a 1. Now, observe that D occurs twice as frequently as B or C. So, in this case, we can represent D here using 1, 0. And then B or C can occur on this branch, but both cannot occur at the same place. So, we need to differentiate between them using another symbol. So, let's do that using 0 and 1 again. So this can be B and this can be C. So B is basically 1, 1, 0 and C will be 1, 1, 1. Now, have we actually saved any bits per symbol? Have we saved the number of questions we ask? Yes, because A occurs more frequently and we need to ask only 1 question. But what is the exact number of questions we have to ask per symbols?